Yeah, Mama BK. Yeah. I'm the mother of all the artists.
Yeah, exactly. You are the mother of all the artists. So it was just a little retouching of the color, bumping it up a little bit because there was just so much of it.
Yeah.
And you know, it's a rock band, and she, like, I saw her at 350 photos. This whole thing, 350 photos that I got down to five.
Wow. 5:30 in the morning,
I went to sleep and woke up at 7:30 in the morning.
Hey.
Hi.
How are you doing?
Oh, elated, excited, nervous. Well, not nervous anymore. I'm like done with that.
Okay, good.
No. Just hot. Overall, totally excited.
Yeah. What was your experience in the last few weeks?
Insane. I thought maybe in the last few weeks I was about to murder somebody and then commit a suicide because trying to get everything together. I mean, and especially in the last 2 weeks, trying to get it all solidified and get the right photo and get it all put together is just insane. I'm running on 2 hours of sleep right now, so. And I feel like I probably slept for 8.
Cool, yes, that's what passion does for you.
Yeah.
Gets you going.
Yeah, it really does. It's a big adrenaline high, so I'm stoked that so many people came, which is awesome. I'm pretty sure all the wine is gone.
It's been gone for a while, yes.
I mean, I think there's 5 bottles maybe still in there, so.
I think we.
Okay.
More than.
I didn't bring myself right now.
No. No, we really had a good showing considering what the weather report was all day.
Yeah, totally.
People braved it. I mean, it hasn't rained yet, but
yeah.
It's supposed to flood.
Yeah, totally. And I'm getting a lot of good feedback about this series, you know, which is interesting. And I think the trick that you were telling me about was take your name tag off and just see what people, hear what people are talking about. And, you know. Some negative, some positive, you know, altogether good. And I like the feedback. I like to be a little fly in the wall, just saying. And a lot of people are getting really good reviews about this one, so which is awesome because that was a last minute thing.
I love this last minute thing. I really that you pulled that one off brilliantly.
Yeah, like out of the hat. Right? Thank you.
Cool. So these were. Why don't you explain this? These. What you were doing with these?
Sure. Okay. So this is my survivalist series. That I've been working on since the beginning of this year, and a lot of the people that you see right here, I mean, they are out in the streets every day. Rain, sleet, snow, 4 seasons, especially 2 of them in New York City seasons that are the toughest to be out there all the time, summer and winter, and they live there. I don't even know if I can do that. And I call them survivalists. They don't have a home, but they're still people, you know? And how do they as people do this Superman thing? Also, there's another aspect to it that a lot of us, you know, people who are going about our day-to-day, trying to go from point A to point B, and I'm guilty of this myself, I pass by them when they ask me for change. I don't see them. I pretend not to see them. But you see them, you know? And they're used to this, of them just passing by, you know? Like this being forgotten, you know? Like, just, you don't see me. Okay. They disappear. And what's funny is that sometimes they want your change, a lot of the times they don't. Because in my experience of doing this series, I found out that, I'm sorry,
I found out that all they really want is a conversation. They just want someone to talk to. And it's powerful. Because that has... I'm tearing up because the simple notion that all they want is a conversation, that's great. I can give you 5 minutes of my time, maybe. Maybe I have an extra half an hour. What are you doing on a Sunday when you're doing particularly nothing? I'm gonna go walk around town, see what happens, right? A lot of people do that. They have half an hour to spend. They don't want to spend it with them. And, I mean, some of them are extraordinary people. And, they've influenced my life so greatly in a positive way, where it makes me want to do this kind of work. You know, maybe not just them, maybe, you know, other things. I don't even know yet, you know what I mean? But I know I'm going to find it and it's going to happen. And this is a passion. I like these portraits. I like getting raw with them, to look into their eyes. I mean, this guy, I mean, he's a handsome dude, you know, but he's in a certain situation that he has to live with. You know, even this guy, that's Paul right there. That's on his side right here. You know, he has a nervousness with his mouth, so I found that particularly interesting. But went to school, graduated college, told him I'm doing this for school, and he was like, good, yeah, all right, you can take my photo. And as soon as you mentioned something about schooling and like doing that kind of work for that, they all of a sudden kind of let loose a little bit and will let me take the photo, which is interesting. And I think it's somewhere in part, like, good for you, you're getting an education, that's good. You'll get a great job, and you know what, if this is part of it, and this can get you to your future, and yeah, I'll be a part of that future. You know, and it totally is. And that's powerful.
Girl. What about this guy?
Anthony, I ran into him just standing there. I mean, I had like a 30-minute conversation with him, born in Brooklyn. He's on 9th Avenue, like in the 30s, like higher 20s, lower 30s. And he looked like a normal guy, but he was just sitting down, but he was asking me for change. And I was just like, oh. I was like, interesting. I was like, you don't look like you need help. And he goes, he's like, brother, I need help. I was like, well, what's your situation? And, you know? I don't want to give too much about his life, you know, because I'd rather someone find him and have a conversation with him. But, drugs, you know? And that's all I'll say about him, but he's a very interesting dude. This one didn't really give me much time at all. I had 2 shots. He was writing something. I come up like behind the fence and I asked him if I could take his photo. And he goes, oh, can't you see I'm writing something? I don't want my photo to be taken. I was just like, it'll be 2 seconds. I'm doing it for school. And he goes, oh, you're doing it for school. All right, one photo. I was like, okay, sure. And I'm like, I'm taking the shot. And it came out like underexposed. And I was like, please make this work. And that was my second shot.
Good shot.
Yeah. And then I was like, thank you. He was like, whatever. And I was like, okay. But a lot of them don't want their photos to take.
Yeah, of course.
I mean, I told you. I went 3 weeks bare. No photo. Every day. Trying to get that photo. Him, I got last minute, and thank God it was there because I just needed it. I needed something to complete this. So, like a roller coaster, I was telling someone earlier, it's been a roller coaster. Ups and downs, I was a bipolar mouse.
Okay.
It was a good experience.
Thank you. I know you jumped on board late in the term. You caught up very quickly. And you produced two very, very simple, small, powerful series.
Thank you. And you are amazing.
No, I'm not. You are.
Well, just take the compliment.
Okay. Thank you, Jason.
Thank you.